Three fun selections for you today. Please welcome to the stage Joey Hendricks to conduct the Polar Express.
Thank you.
Thank you for holding. Our next piece is Sinterklaas's Rooftop Ride, which is from the Dutch tradition of Santa Claus. And the composer, Laura Estes, was just imagining in the Netherlands where it's very cold, Santa Claus probably slips and slides a lot as he's delivering the toys to all the children. So this is supposed to be a funny sort of slapstick comedy, and you'll hear a lot of things that reminisce of sleigh ride, like horse hooves and a trumpet whinny at the end, as well as quotes from other holiday music as well. And it's supposed to be pretty funny. So enjoy Sinterklaas's Rooftop Ride. Children or any people young at heart who'd like to come on up for the reading of Twas the Night Before Christmas. Dr. Lansky, would you join us, please? Just a quick thought, a personal thought. This chair was my grandmother's chair. I remember this chair from the time I was, as long as I can remember, it even has a spot underneath of the drawer for a phone book in it, like a legit old-style phone book. And the right side, Ms. Dr. Lansky, if you want to write a letter, there's like a desk that's built in it as well. So I love using this chair, it's special to me. Do we have any children who are coming up to listen? I hope so. It's not as cool without you. If you brought a stuffy, PJs, you're not too cool for it, it's awesome. Parents, you're welcome to come up with your children if that would make it easier as well. Again, this is our final piece, and I appreciate you being here with us. This is the classic story, Twas the Night Before Christmas, with band accompaniment. Dr. Lansky, that's all yours.
What an awesome concert. Thank you, Mr. Smith and Ms. Prue and Mr. Hendricks. What a round, let's have a round of applause for all of our musicians and staff. All right, are we ready? Twas the Night Before Christmas. Oh, sorry. You start then. I'm ready. Before Christmas, when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. Just settle down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donder and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all. Before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew with a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkle, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each tiny hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. Bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry, his cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke had encircled his head like a wreath. He had a bad habit. We don't really do that. He had a broad face and a round little belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
Thanks for coming, everybody. Have a great evening, great vacation, and Happy New Year.